Hello, I'm Terrence Brennan with Houdini.com. I'm the chef proprietor of Picheline and artisanal restaurants here in Manhattan, New York. And today I'm going to share with you how to compose a cheese plate. Both my restaurants are very well known for the artisanal cheese plates that they serve. In fact, my restaurant Artisanal has a cheese shop right inside the restaurant. So I am what you call a cheese head. And the cheese course is becoming very, very popular in restaurants today. As a matter of fact, any restaurant with its grain of salt has to have a cheese course. So what to think about when composing a cheese plate? There are basically three types of milk: sheep, cow, and goat. Goat cheeses, this is a Montenegro from Spain. It's a very firm, very piquant type of cheese. And this is a Cloquebitou from the French Pyrenees, aged about 3 months in this beautiful little cylinder. And it's a very, very pungent goat cheese. Next we're gonna go to Azidon. And this is a very kind of runny cheese. I call it spoonable, where you actually cut the top off of this and spoon it out. And this is a sheep's milk cheese from Portugal. And then we have Hoki Brie, which is a cow's milk cheese from Switzerland. This is a mountain cheese like Comté or Gruyère type of cheese. Then we're going to have a Fougerou, which is in the Bloomy Rind family, like Camemberts, and everyone knows Brie. This is similar to a Brie, but not in the Brie district, but it's a very creamy, same texture as a Brie, and has this lovely fern as a garnish. Then we have the great cheese of Roquefort. This is a sheep's milk cheese. Sometimes the blue cheese can be made with cow's milk, salty, crumbly. Love this. The classic combination is with Sauternes. You want to make sure that you purchase artisanal cheeses. What are artisanal cheeses? They're cheeses that are made by craftsmen, by small farms, made in small batches, of very high quality, great milk, made with integrity, passion, and love. And you really taste the difference in these cheeses. So now we have our categories, and now we want to compose a cheese plate. So I like to do 3 to 5 cheeses on a cheese plate. So I like to at least include 2 different types of milk, and then 2 different types of style of cheese, being a blue or a firm or a wash rind cheese. So in composing that, we want to do about 2 to 3 ounces of cheese per person. Now I've assembled 5 cheeses here. This is a slice of the Montenegro. This is the Azidon. And this is the Fougerou, the Hoki Brie, and then our Roquefort. What's real important is that we serve these cheeses at room temperature. Very, very important, because it allows all these wonderful aromas and flavors to come through. If you serve it ice cold out of the box, it retards all these flavors. Not good for the cheeses. Then you want to serve them left to right, or if you're on a round plate, starting at 12 o'clock, clockwise, the mildest to the strongest, because you don't want to start with the blue cheese and then try and taste something mild like the Fougerou, which would, the blue cheese would overpower that and you'd miss all those little nuances and flavors. So start left to right, strongest to mildest to strongest. And then an often question asked is, what do you serve with cheeses? I'm a purist, so I would just eat this with a fork and knife. But many people enjoy it with some bread, some walnut bread or a baguette. Some garnishes here. We have a fig and walnut cake, a dried fig and walnut cake that's pressed and made from Spain. Montenegro, which is these little, they're kind of like a big tannic apple that you have to cook down to a caramel like this, and it's made into a fruit paste. These beautiful Mulchel dates from California. And then we make our own chutney here that goes great with some of the harder cheeses and some cheddars. Well, here it is. This is my perfect cheese plate. I've covered a couple different milks. I have a few different textures. I have soft, firm, gooey, and I always have a blue on my cheese platter. What I also love about entertaining with cheese is how easy and sophisticated it is. The hardest thing you have to remember is to pull it out of the refrigerator 2 hours before you want to serve it. And that's Entertaining with Cheese. I'm Terrence Brennan for Houdini.com.